good afternoon, YouTube. So I'm going to be using my new utility sink to help flush the tankless water heater. So the idea is you want to circulate a cleaning solution or descaling solution like white vinegar through the heater for about 45 minutes to an hour. And you do that by using a pump in a bucket. So I've got my vinegar in the bucket, got the pump in there, and according to the Takagi instructions, first thing I've got to do is run the hot water for about 2 minutes here. Okay, it's been about 2 minutes, and then the instructions are you pull the power plug. And you shut off the water. Okay, now with the power shut off, you close your service port, so this shuts off the cold and hot water. And you need to pop the pressure relief valve here. A little bit of water dripping out there. And then you get your service ports here. There's a little bit of water in there. So then here is my almost free water heater cleaning kit. These are the old hot and cold water lines that used to run to the clothes washer. And so I've just replaced the washers inside and then fitted them with some right angle adapters here just so they go on a little easier. So now I can open the hot water there, let that water drain out. And let me do the same with the cold here. Yeah, those right angle adapters are nice. They're a lot easier to work with than just your knurled hose fitting. So let me open up the cold here. Just drain the water out of the heater. And then I wanted to check the filter here. I saw one video that said you should check this just to see how the filter is looking there. So that's looking pretty good. You want to do the same flow direction as the heater would work. So I have my cold water pipe here is going to hook up to the pump outlet. So let me screw that on there. So I hook up my pump. So the pump's going to pump vinegar up the hose into the cold water side. It'll go through that filter screen to catch any scale and whatnot that might get sucked up, and then it'll circulate through the heater core and then come out the hot water. And the important thing you want to do is, this is the hot line right here, run that back into your bucket, because what you're going to do is circulate the vinegar up and then it'll run back. Okay, we've got all the hoses hooked up and there we go. There's our vinegar coming through. Let me check the time here. Yeah, so we're about 5:30 in the afternoon, so I'm going to run this till about 6:15 and we'll see what it looks like. And you can see it's actually getting some crud out of there. Wow. Once a year is probably a good time to do that flush. So anyway, there we go. I'll bring you back in about 45 minutes and we'll see what the vinegar looks like there. Okay, YouTube, been about 45 minutes. Let me shut off the pump here. And there, we're draining out the water. Pump gets a little bit warm. I've never run it this long and it's a pretty hot day today. Now what you're supposed to do is disconnect this. So I think I'll try to move this off to the side. And the next thing you're supposed to do is run cold water through the heater. And since my faucet has a hose thread right on the end, I'm just going to run this. There we go. Now we're running the cold water through there to flush out the vinegar. So you're supposed to let that go a few minutes. So let's see, I got to get the pump out of here. Maybe I'll set it off to the side and let it drip dry a little bit. I think that should be good, so I'm going to shut the cold water off. That's flushed through the heater a couple of times, and then we'll take this off, let the water drain out of there, and then we go up and basically reverse with all the valves here.
Yeah, so you close this one here, close this one here, that shuts off the two service ports. There's the hot, and there's the cold back open, and then I can remove the lines here and put the caps back on. Take off the hot there, there's the hot line.
Yeah, these are really nice. I'll put a link to these. I picked these up off of Amazon, and having those tabs on there makes it really easy, and having the right angle. Okay, YouTube, one thing I forgot to do was to check the inlet filter, and you can see it definitely picked up a lot of crud in there. It was pretty clean before, but you got to rinse that out. Let me do that here. You definitely generate a lot of crud. All the sediment that comes out of descaling ends up back in here, so you got to clean this out afterwards. Good idea to check it beforehand, but definitely check it afterwards. That was definitely plugged up. I might give it one more rinse, so that just screws in right up next to the cold water valve there, or cold water pipe.
And the last thing to do is I'll plug the heater back in,
and there we go. It's booting back up, so no error codes, all zeros, and it's back to sleep. So there we go, we got the water heater flushed. So I set up a reminder in my calendar that every May I'm supposed to flush this water heater. Now problem is it's June because I had to get the sink put in place, but that was the main reason I wanted a sink here, was for that water heater, because if I have to do this every year, now I don't make much of a mess, you know, just water in the sink and that'll all dry out. So yeah, I think I can get the pump out of here now. It's still got a little water in it, or vinegar, so let the pump dry out, but that's a nice thing. I can keep everything here in the sink. The sink's big enough, I can have the pump, the bucket, the hoses, do all the flushing. That is a successful result in my book. So now I know how to do flushing the heater. I can now clear the reminder in my calendar from this year, and next year in May I will get another reminder to come out here and do the same thing again. But yeah, seems to work really well. So I think I've got hot water again, and the heater's good for another year. So I just wanted to show you the descaling process on the Takagi tankless water heater. That was the first big project in the new utility sink. So I think everything passed with flying colors. So if you have any questions about the flushing descaling procedure, post up in the comment section below, and I'll put some of the other videos over here on the left side. You might be interested in those. And as always, thanks for watching.